Yeah, what is it? Oh my, someone new. I'm so sorry. You must think I'm terribly rude. Welcome to Carol's place. I'm Carol. It's not much, I know, but it's mine. So if you need anything, just let me know. Greta will get you any food you want, and I handle the rooms. It's so good to have someone new here, even if it is an ugly old smooth skin. I'm kidding, I'm just kidding. Don't make that face. You'll love it here. Gob? Yes, of course. He's my son. Well, not really. Not like you would think of a son. We ghouls don't really work like that. But I love him like he's my own. Do you know him? Have you seen him? Is he all right? No. Not Gob. I'm sorry. I need some time alone. Hey, goddammit, why did you tell Carol that Gob was dead? You couldn't have kept that to yourself? You know not everyone needs to hear the truth about everything. She was perfectly fine thinking that he'd found happiness out there. Just order something and get away from me. To tell you the truth, hon, I don't really know much about it. All I know is that it used to be some sort of exhibit. Something about hell or the afterlife or something. Tulip knows that sort of stuff. Not like anyone around here ever buys anything from that shop of hers. Come back when you're hungry.
Carol just seems so sad these days.
Actually, I haven't noticed at all. Carol just seems so sad, Mr. Crowley.
I don't really pay attention.
Oh, please.
I only came here because I can't stand the Ninth Circle. That place is just nasty. Even I think so. Good to see you, Mr. Crowley. Yes, yes, hello. I don't know why everyone around here insists on being so damn friendly. What the hell did you wake me up for, smooth skin? What are you staring at? You think you'd never seen a ghoul up close before?
Some kind of spontaneously beneficial business arrangement. I'd ask the kid from 101, but I hear he's busy oogling some newly obtained piece of Commonwealth.
Is that so? Even if I call you a milk-sucking, mutant-loving, water-stealing son of a whore?
I like a human that knows this place. Too many of you think we're all just zombies. They don't know or don't care that we're just as human as they are inside. We bleed, we hurt, we regret. And you know what really pisses me off? They think the only way to kill us is to shoot us in the head, like in the old zombie stories, and that'll put us out of our misery. Hey, I know. Maybe you could help me even the score. Not everyone is as sympathetic to ghouls as you are. In fact, some humans are downright bigots. They treat us like zombies, calling us brain eaters and shufflers. Well, I'm gonna make them pay. Before I get into the details, you don't have anything against killing, do you? Well, aren't you the bloodthirsty type? I got this list of people. Ghoul bigots. Real scum. I've only got 4 guys left on the list. Started out with 11. All of them hate ghouls and treat us like we're zombies. They all deserve to die, but it has to be done with a headshot, just like the old stories where zombies can only be killed that way. I'll pay you 100 caps for each one, 25 if they die some other way. Excellent. Take this sniper rifle. You'll need it. Here's a list of the guys and their last known locations. Word will get around if Tenpenny's killed, but I'll need proof for the others. Bring me back something personal from each of them as proof. like a key or a ring or something. They're ghoul haters. I want them all dead. Don't you think that's enough? It's a place for ghouls. Here, we're just people, not monsters. There are too many places where a ghoul can't get a fair shake.
Later.
This is our town. You best be careful.
That changes right here, right now. From this moment onward, the children of this great nation are its highest priority. The Enclave will restore...
We don't get a lot of your kind down here.
Reinstate every youth program and offer counseling and financial assistance to any family in need.
Hey, man, what's happening?
No. Go talk to Azrakal. I don't care.
Hello.
Well now, looky here. We got us a smooth skin that I ain't ever seen before. I'm Azrakal. And this is the Ninth Circle. Folks got problems, and I got liquor to sell them. Well, liquor and a few other pick-me-ups. You need anything, you just let me know. That's Sharon. Let's just say, well, he's a loyal employee. Don't mess with me, and he won't mess with you. I hold his contract, which makes me his employer. He will do what I ask, when I ask, without question. You see, Sharon grew up around a very interesting group of individuals. They, well, I guess you could say that they brainwashed him. He is absolutely loyal to whomever holds his contract. Unfailing, unflinching, until the day that employment ends. Don't get me wrong. I have no doubt that he holds no end of animosity towards me. But so long as he is my employee, he is as gentle as a teddy bear. His company is rather refreshing, isn't it? But don't mistake his brevity for stupidity. That would be very unwise. Underestimating an opponent has been the last mistake of far too many individuals throughout history. Watches over the bar, keeps the drunks in line. Pretty much, I point at something and Sharon hurts it. He's the best thug a corrupt bartender could ever ask for. He never bothers me with his own annoying sense of morality. Very well. You ask too many questions as it is. Yeah, just east of here. Bunch of guys with guns are holed up there. If I start telling tales about my customers, I'll lose all of them. Yeah, well, don't let it happen again. Why, whatever do you mean? I'm a simple barkeep, nothing more. Ah, an educated consumer. My favorite kind. Yes, yes, I think I can help you. Simply step over here, my friend, and I'll show you my stock of more potent goods. While there is no law in Underworld per se, I'd rather not end up at the receiving end of an angry lynch mob. There's no shortage of do-gooders around here, and it would be just like them to take it upon themselves to interfere in a fair business transaction. Honestly, I have something to sell, and you want to buy it. Now, why is that anyone else's business, huh? As you wish, my friend. It's the only place in the capital wasteland where my people can escape the misery of the world above. And that misery, well, it makes a man like me very happy and very, very wealthy. Everyone's got troubles, and everyone brings them to me.
I hope you don't mind the smell. I know how sensitive you humans can be.
Come on, boys! Fresh meat! It's go time!
Oh, hell yes!
Fresh blood, just right for the...
Keep